colder. We are realistically going to be talking single-digit high temperatures soon. So if we haven't gotten that winter bite or you haven't felt it yet, it is definitely on the way. And before that, we are seeing the snow in spots, the wintry mix, even some light freezing drizzle. You can see out near Panora is some heavier stuff, and off north of Boone as well. Not seeing a lot through the metro, even up to Madrid or Ames, but there will be potential as we head into the next 12 to 24 hours of seeing exactly that. A different picture, though, out in Olean, Iowa early this morning. Absolutely beautiful sunrise. They still had the clouds out there, but that helped to shape this wonderful sunrise. And again, keep sending in your pictures of that, too. Absolutely beautiful stuff. I'm a bit of a sucker for that myself, but we've definitely got the clouds that are going to help to block that out for the next couple days here. You can see that surging moisture coming in from the south, even a bit of a rain-snow mix down near Omaha and the Missouri-Iowa border, and that will be continuing as the system continues to lift northeastward. So plan on a mix today, tonight, into tomorrow as well. If you have any travel plans, could get slick at times. Temperatures remaining fairly mild. I know wind chills will be in that mid-20s range, but we top out 37 already at noon tomorrow as we keep the clouds in that mix alive. Should be a general transition from mix over to light rain through the overnight hours, but could still see some freezing drizzle into the morning hours. Just be safe if you're headed out and about at all. And this is a look at the systems that we've got that are pushing through, bringing us in this mixed bag of precipitation. Largely snow to the north, not talking large amounts of accumulations, will remain a half inch or less. You can see this transition over to rain, though, from the south as we bring in a little bit more warmth and a bit more moisture. Futurecast handling this reasonably well. Keeps us socked in with the cloud cover as we head throughout the day and into the evening and continues to push that snow northward. And then you can see we start to warm things up a little bit to the south. That's going to help to drive in that rain that we've got that'll be on deck for us really all day tomorrow and into Friday, too. It's light stuff to start the day, but as that surges in, we continue to see the rain chances on the increase throughout the day. So if you've got outdoor plans, know that they will be fairly soggy as you head throughout the day. But again, not talking huge amounts as far as totals go. Rainfall totals sit around a half an inch. Snowfall totals up off to the north and to the east, still looking at around a half inch to an inch, but just enough to potentially make those roads slush covered and slick. So please be safe if you're headed out. 35 today for a high. You look all across the area, we're in that mid-30s range along with the clouds and that mixed precipitation that we carry over into the evening, likely transitioning some of that over into rain and eventually all of it over into rain as we head throughout the day on Thursday. But that's going to continue with us on Friday. And once this system passes, we get an Arctic punch like no other. 9 degrees is your high on Sunday. So that chilly air, that Arctic air, that's going to be here for a bit.
A punch is very accurate, isn't it?
Yeah, or slap in the face.
Either one. I know it.